Hello and welcome to Storysium, and thanks for watching this Premiere Pro tutorial. Today we're going to look at the basics of using keyframes inside Premiere Pro. Editing with keyframes gives you a lot of control and it also enables you to be more creative. So the first question is, what are keyframes? Well, in editing software like Premiere, a keyframe is a frame used to indicate the beginning or the end of a change made to a parameter. This is often used to make animations or to change the value of an applied effect. Maybe this still is a little cryptic, so let me do an example to show you what I mean. Here inside Premiere, we've got a clip on the timeline with a logo image on top. If I give this a playback, you can see that the logo zooms in, and that is done with two simple keyframes. So when I select the logo layer and then go to the effects control panel, you can see that there are two default linear keyframes visible here on the timeline. And when I put the playhead at the first keyframe, you can see that the value is 100%. And if I go forward to the next keyframe, you can see that this is set to 200%. So basically, this animation is going from scaling value A to B. Straightforward and simple. And if I open up the properties, you can see that the scaling here is represented inside the graph. This graph can be very helpful to do more complex animations. Now let me show you how to create keyframes. And to do this, I will first create a simple circle with the shape tool. We're going to animate this circle to move from the left to the right. Make sure you've got the layer selected on the timeline and head over to the effects control panel. And here you can enable keyframes by clicking on the stopwatch icon here. This will automatically create the first keyframe at the point of the playhead. This little diamond-shaped icon here on the timeline represents the keyframe. Now if you move forward in time and change the position value, Premiere will create another keyframe. And with these two keyframes, we've now created this basic animation. As you can see, this is a basic linear animation without any form of smoothness. For a lot of cases, this is more than enough, but for some animations, we want some more smoothness, right? Well, to do this, we need to change the properties of the keyframe. And to demonstrate this, we're going to add another keyframe. I will change the position of the circle again, and this will automatically create another keyframe for us. Now we've created this animation with three linear keyframes. Now to make this animation smoother, we're going to right click on the first keyframe and then go to interpolation options and select ease out. And as you can see, this smoothened the velocity curve in the beginning of the graph. We can now do the same for the last keyframe, but for this one, we need to select the ease in variant. And again, you can see a smooth curve towards the end of the animation. For the mid keyframe, we could use a bezier keyframe. This will ease the animation around the area of the keyframe. Let's give it a playback to see the results and also do a side-by-side comparison so you can see the difference. If you want, you can also change the timing of the keyframes. You can simply select them with your mouse and then drag them to the left or the right, like this. If you position the keyframes this way, the animation will go much faster. You can also manually adjust the movement and smoothness of the animation. If you click on one of the keyframes, you can see that there's a blue handle here in the graph. If you select one of these points, you can drag it to the left or the right to create a ramp or a curve. And you could do the same for each individual point on the graph. So now I've created a ramp in the middle. If I give this a playback, you'll see that it speeds up in the middle of the animation. And now if I pick one of the points in the middle and then drag it all the way to the right, you will get a very different result. It will speed up until it reached the first keyframe and then slow down immediately and then speed up again. And this way, the options are endless when it comes down to keyframe animations. Another option is to create hold keyframes. This does exactly what it sounds like. It holds the current value until the next keyframe. To demonstrate this, I will first add a few more keyframes. Then I'll select them all, right click and then select the hold option. And if I give this a playback, you can see that it now holds position until the next keyframe. So far, you have now learned how to use keyframes for animations. But there is more. You can also use them for almost any effect inside Premiere. Let's look at a few examples, and for this I'm going to use free clips from Videvo. Videvo is a great site to download free and premium stock footage. I will add some download links in the video description so you can download them as well and practice along with the tutorial. So here I've got a couple of these clips on the timeline. I'm going to move over to the effects panel to apply a couple of effects. First, I'm going to search for the tint effect and I'm going to apply this to the first clip. And then we're going to search for the famous lens flare effect and apply this to the second clip. And for the third one, we're going to use the find edges effect. Now I will select the first clip and then head over to the effects control panel. In here, we're going to enable keyframes for the amount of tint. First keyframe created, so now let's move forward in time and then change the value so it will create another one. And if I give this a playback, you can see that with these two keyframes, we've made the effect gradually shift from black and white to color. Let's move over to the next example, and that is the lens flare. I'm going to enable keyframes for flare center and flare brightness. And I'm also going to shift the position to make the lens flare move along with the camera movement. I'm also going to reduce the brightness. And this is the result that we created in a few simple clicks. Let's also quickly do the last one, and here we've got the find edges effect. I'm going to enable keyframes for blend with original, and then I'm going to move forward in time and change the value so it will create another keyframe. And again, this is what we've created with a few simple keyframes. Well, as you've seen, editing with keyframes can be a very powerful tool inside Premiere. With keyframes, you can be very creative and create a lot of awesome things. So be sure to master this if you want to take your video editing skills to the next level. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then please like the video. That really helps a lot. Or leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.